faith is in God. Tell him what you want. Tell him what you want. He ain't no mind reader. You know what you want.
This is a song that the Lord gave me not too long ago. It's a simple song. I want you to learn and sing along.
We give you the praise.
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 Lift your hand. Lift your hand over the place. I say, Lord, we bless you. Lord, we thank you for 7 years. Hallelujah. But this praise is going to be for the next 7 years to come. Anybody ready for 7 more years? 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 Hey! Anybody ready for 7 more years? 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 We give you the praise.
Give you the praise.
We give you the praise.
Give you the praise.
We give you the praise.
Give you the praise.
We give you the praise.
Give you the praise.
We give you the praise.
Give you the praise.
We give you the praise.
Give you the praise.
We give you the praise.
Give you the praise.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
7 more years of glory. Lift your hand. 7 more years of power. Come on, give him glory. 7 more years of prosperity. I prophesy over you. 7 more years of greatness. 7 more years of impact and influence in this city, in this nation. 7 more years, you're just beginning. Tell your neighbor, you're just beginning. God has just begun to do his greatest work in your lives. You ain't seen nothing yet. Tobago ain't seen nothing yet. Trinidad ain't seen nothing yet. The islands of the Caribbean ain't seen nothing yet. We're just warming up. Tell them about, we're just warming up, warming up, warming up. We're warming up. Hallelujah. We give you the praise.
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 Somebody
scream. Make some noise in the house. And let the heavens be glad, because our God reigns. Hey, 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 hey,
hey,
hey,
hey,
hey, hey,
hey,
my God,
hey, 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 hey,
hey, hallelujah. My God, hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
God is awesome, amen.
Amen.
And he's worthy of all the praise.
Amen.
We don't hold anything back, amen.
Because
we don't want him to hold back anything from us.
Amen.
Don't say, Lord,
Lord,
don't hold back anything from me tonight.
Everything you have for me tonight,
release it to me. Because I know tomorrow you'll have some other stuff for me.
Release tonight.
What's for me tonight?
For me.
Put your hands together. Give God praise, because it's going to happen. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. Based on your expectation, God is going to bless you tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Wow, I'm pumped. I'm excited to be here. I came all the way from New York just for tonight. Amen. Came all the way from New York just to be here with you tonight. So you know, amen, that tonight is a special night. Tell 4 people, tonight is a special night.
Tonight is a special night.
Tonight, 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 tonight. Hey! Tonight! Glory to God! Woo! Glory to God!
Hallelujah.
Have your seats. Thank you. I want to minister the word, and I want to minister to you tonight. They're going to have a little ministry. Tonight there's going to be healings. Tonight there's going to be deliverances. Tonight some of you are going to have your breakthrough. Glory to God. Some of you are going to get lifted up tonight. Freedom is going to come to your lives tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. I want us to put our hands together for all of the leaders and all the elders of People of Destiny. Come on, put your hands together for them. Glory to God. Cannot have a strong church without good leadership. Amen. You can't have a strong anything without good, strong, healthy leaders. Amen. Amen. And our church has been able to survive for 7 years. Persons thought they would never make it because the first thing they asked is, where's the pastor? Amen. And when there's no resident pastor in the house, per se, as they perceive it, they can see church as happening. Amen. But this is an apostolic work. Amen. And the prophetic people. Yeah. The church is a runner. Yeah. Or covered by the Holy Spirit. Yes. God uses men and he uses women. But at the end of the day, it is the Holy Spirit. That's why the prophet prophesied and said, this is the church. Yeah. That obeys God. Yeah. And whatever the Spirit of the Lord says, that's what we do. So we are a prophetic church. So we didn't have much of a chance. Yeah, but look at what the Lord has done. Amen. And as I said, he's just warming up. While we were in the midst of worship, the Lord said to me, look at the disciples. Don't look. Jesus never looked at the crowd. He always looked at the disciples, the ones who were faithful, the ones who were committed from the beginning. You got it. There it is. Amen. Those are the ones. He said, look at them. Hallelujah. Let's give God praise tonight because you are here. You are here. You are here. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You are here. And there's a blessing. There's a blessing for those who have been proven faithful. Glory to God. You must be found faithful in God and the things of God. And there's always a blessing attached to that. Amen. Tell your neighbor you're in for a blessing. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let's open up our Bibles. We're going to look at Mark chapter 2 from verse 1 to 5. I want to share a word of God with you and then release. We're going to flow in the Holy Spirit tonight for great things to happen among us. Amen. It's 7 years of anniversary. And we believe God for great things. 7 is a happy number in the kingdom of God. Amen. Tell your neighbor, 7 is a happy number. Wonderful. It's a wonderful number. Amen. And God's going to do some powerful things in our lives tonight. Mark chapter 2, 1 to 5. It reads, a few days later, when Jesus entered Capernaum, the people heard that he had come home. They gathered in such large numbers that there was no room left, not even outside the door, and he preached the word to them. Some men came, bringing to him a paralyzed man. Somebody say a paralyzed man. Carried by 4 of them. Since they could not get him to Jesus because of the crowd, they made an opening in the roof above Jesus by digging through it and then lowered the mat the man was lying on. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralyzed man, son, your sins are forgiven. Son, your sins are forgiven. Tonight, I want to talk to you about paralysis. My goal is that at the end of my message to you, you would be paralyzed no more. Paralyzed no more. To be paralyzed, whether partly or wholly, is to be incapable of movement. So whenever a part of your body, let's go physical, is paralyzed, that part of the body is unable to move. To be paralyzed also means to render someone unable to think or act normally, especially through panic or fear. So when you're afraid, you don't act or you don't think normally, going somewhere. To be paralyzed also means to bring to a standstill, as in an organization or even a church. By causing disruption or chaos. Somebody say paralyzed. So we have these three understandings of the word paralyzed. So it can be physical. Yeah. It can be institutional. It can be emotional. Amen. And I want to talk to you a few more. It can be also personal. It can be relational. I'll talk to you about that in a little while. But what I want you to get in mind is this, and I want you, as I minister the word of God to you, to see yourself in the word. See yourself in the word. Because a lot of times when the word comes, we deflect the word. We say, that word is for Sister Sue, you know. She should have been in church tonight. Oh, come, Apostle, preach that word for she. How come she ain't come? No, this word, everybody said me, this word is for me. Hallelujah. Because once you keep looking at someone else, you'll never see yourself. You've got to look at you so that you can see yourself in the word, so that the word of God can change your life and your circumstance and your situation. Are we together tonight? So the Bible tells us this man was paralyzed. Clearly, he could not move. He couldn't move because the Bible says that four men had to carry him. And one of the things about not being able to move is that it's not a nice thing. Not a nice thing. We were born for movement. Even babies, while they're in the womb, they're in there kicking. That's how you know things happening inside there. Glory to God. Kicking here, kicking there. Movement going on in the womb. We were born for movement. Glory to God. But when you are paralyzed, you are stuck. And some people have been stuck in the same place for a little too long. Tell your neighbor, a little too long. So this word comes tonight to liberate you so that you can move forward. Tell your neighbor, we're going forward. Because sometimes, let me tell you what happens sometimes to churches. They come to a good place and they get stuck there. Tell your neighbor, not us. We're not going to get stuck in a good place. We were wired for movement. We're going to go forward. Hallelujah. When you are paralyzed, you become dependent on others. Someone has to carry you. Someone has to move you. Amen? You become dependent on others. And watch this, because this is important. Because a lot of time we don't see ourselves as being paralyzed, yes? But whenever you become dependent on others, there's a form of paralysis operating in your life. There are some things, let me tell you something. Listen, God is so amazing in his creation, in his creativity. When we are babies, we must depend on our parents or our guardians. But then when we become mature, yeah, we're supposed to become interdependent. Not independent, but interdependent in a way where I offer myself to you and you offer yourself to me. It's not that if, and this is good, I want you to get this. It's not that if you don't offer yourself to me that I'm going to die. Because some people behave like that. Yeah? Yeah, they think that's what They think you wouldn't make it. Glory to God. We all have something to offer each other. But don't make the mistake, Papa. I'm going to survive without you. Oh, glory. Don't make the mistake now. Are you with me? I have something to offer you, and you have something to offer me. And we've got to relate to each other on that level. Yeah? But there are some people who believe that if they don't love you, you're going to die. And the sad thing is that some of you behave like if they don't love you, you go die. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It's wonderful to be loved. You understand? But you got to know, Papa, if you decide tomorrow that you ain't love me no more, I'm going to still survive. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, I was born to make it. That's why you've got to get unstuck. Hallelujah. Because when you are stuck in a place and when you have become paralyzed and become dependent on people, on others, guess what happens? You become a prime candidate for abuse. People abuse you and take advantage of you. And some of you have been in that place, but in the 70th anniversary of People of Destiny, no more paralyzed, no more. That abuse is going to stop. We'll bring an end to it. Glory to God. When you are stuck, people take advantage of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When you are stuck, hallelujah. One of the things why they take advantage of you is because you are not in a place to stand up for your rights. You're not in a position. Hallelujah. Because something's not working right. Something is paralyzed in you. Glory to God. Some area in your life, some part of your body is not functioning as God designed it to function. So people know that no matter what you think or no matter what you say, if they don't carry you, you ain't going anywhere. It's like you lost your rights. Hallelujah. You know, back in the day, they don't do it now. But back in the day, when you're going out, they always tell you, walk with your vex money. Today's your what? Walk with your vex card. So when you go out, if you and the boyfriend or the girlfriend or the husband or whoever fall out, you have something in here. Glory to God. Hallelujah. When they tell you, get out my car, you say, no problem. You get out the car and you just flag down one because you have money here. But when you don't have anything, glory to God. Hallelujah. You have no rights. You can't even open your mouth. Tell your neighbor, not anymore. Not anymore, not anymore. God is about to do something awesome in this place tonight. There's going to be freedom in this place tonight. Some of you that's been in a place where you've been stuck and you've been taken advantage of, what you don't realize is that you have the power within you to move from that place. I'm going to show you in the word of God tonight because you're a child of God. When you are stuck, when you're paralyzed and you're stuck in one place, listen, all you can do is dream of bigger and greater things, but you can never get there. And some of you have been dreaming for a long, long time, but it's time for you to get closer to your destiny and get closer to your future because God has a great purpose and God has a great plan for your lives. Listen, church, the plans of God are to prosper you, to give you a hope, and to give you a future. God has greatness on his mind when he thinks about you. Don't let anybody tell you anything less than that. Hallelujah. And it's time. You see, a lot of time we can have great dreams. We can have great visions. We can think very innovative, and we can have all of these things going on, but we don't move towards it. It's time to move. And some of us have been dreaming for too long. We have the plans on the table for too long. Now it's time for you to take action. Actually do the thing. How many have been dreaming about the house for so long? How many have been dreaming? Listen. Yes, I know you put the application in for the house. How long you gonna wait? I'm talking to somebody. This may not be for everybody. How long are you going to wait? Back in the day, there was nobody giving anybody any house. You gotta be careful. Listen to me. You have a vision. You have a plan. You start working it. And sometimes, let me tell you something. You see the God we serve, it's either we serve him or we don't serve him. If you're waiting for man to give you something, well, don't say it's God. But if you're waiting on God to give you something, then God is looking at what you are doing to move, to take action towards the dream that he has placed in your heart. Don't sit down and wait. You're waiting for this and you're waiting for that. It's time for action. Tell everybody, it's time for action. Glory to God. Maybe when you start taking action to move towards your vision, God's going to open up the door for you. God's going to put your name on the top of the list. God's going to make your name come up on the lottery. Some of you have given your names in and you made the application. But for help me, God, if they call it today, you ain't ready. You ain't ready. You ain't got nothing. You ain't got no money saved. Listen to me. You've got to start taking action to move towards your vision. So 5 years from now, 10 years from now, you are closer. You are telling neighbor, I'm about to move towards my dream, towards my vision. I'm tired of waiting. I'm tired of depending on somebody. Listen to me. While you are depending on them, they got a whole lot of other people in front of you. You in the back of the line. Listen to me. You got to get up, build your own momentum, take some things into action. Listen to me. And start doing some things about your situation. Surround yourself with the right people. I'm going ahead of my message. Surround yourself with the right people. This guy, he was paralyzed, but he had the right people around him. Glory to God. Listen to me. I tell you. Let me talk to me. I tell all you. If you're broke, don't hang out with broke people. Glory to God. If you're having problems in your marriage, don't hang out with people who have no man. Girl, if it was me, I don't leave it tail already. That's why she ain't have none. Glory to God. Listen, surround yourself. Listen, if you're paralyzed, don't hang out with other paralyzed people. Who gonna help one another? Nobody can help each other. Glory to God. If one leg ain't working, you need somebody who has two legs to work. Oh, you ain't want me. I'm warming up. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Listen to me. That's why I'm going off. Tell your neighbor she's about to go off. Tell your neighbor she goes off every now and again. That's why I endorse. If you're an old woman, don't marry an old man. She just went off. You have arthritis. You have high blood pressure. You have diabetes. What are you doing? What you going to pick up somebody with the same thing for? Who can help you? And if you're an older man, what are you looking for an old woman for? Look for a young woman. My God. Hallelujah. You have back problems. You have all kind of problems. Tell anybody she went off. Surround yourself with the right people. Get rid of the backbiters. Get rid of the confusion makers. Get rid of the haters. Get rid of the losers. Listen to me. Surround yourself with people who love you for who you are. Who accept you for who you are. Who don't judge you for who you are, but they want to see you become better. Sunday, I'm going to wrap that one up. Somebody say paralysis. Paralysis. When you are paralyzed, it means that there's something in you that was designed to work, but it's not working anymore. Paralysis. Say paralysis. Now let's break it down. I want to talk about four areas of paralysis that we need to pay attention to and find ourselves in tonight so that the Lord can heal us. Four areas of paralysis. First area we're going to look at is physical paralysis. Somebody say physical paralysis. No, paralysis occurs when the muscle in that area of the body loses its function. It loses it. In other words, the muscle is not working. And when that happens, there is no communication to and from the brain to that part of the body. Tell your neighbor your brain is important now. Because the brain, for those of you who are biology specialists or specialize in that area and so forth, I'm a preacher, so don't judge me tonight. But the brain is what sends the signals throughout the body so that the body knows what it needs to do. Amen? That's right. So when that system is not working and there's no communication to that part of the body can't work because the body's not receiving the messages. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. It's not receiving the message. So when that happens, a lot of other things can happen. My God. When the message is not, when the body is unable to receive proper communication from the brain, and paralysis is operating in the body, you can lose things like your bladder control. Areas of your body start malfunctioning. When you don't have bladder control, then it means that things get messy around you. You start embarrassing yourself and others, those who are connected to you. I'm going somewhere. You can develop things like urinary tract infections. When you're paralyzed because you're lying maybe in one spot, you can develop bed sores.
Your faith is in God. Tell him what you want. Tell him what you want.
Simple song. I want you to learn and sing along. It just says, I will sing.